Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. We just pulled up at one of the biggest salvage stores that we have in our area. It is called R&S Salvage Grocery. It is in Hart County, and I have not been able to come since we moved, and I'm so excited. So this one is not just discount grocery items. It also has like Amish baked goods. They even have a huge frozen section. And I think they have a refrigerated section as well. So I'm so excited to head in. Let's see what all we can find. Okay, guys, we are back home. I was so happy that I was able to get to R&S. I love it. Like I said, it has been years and I had not been able to even go since we moved. So I spent $100.31. So I'm gonna share everything that we got. Now this one, like I said, has like a bakery and also some like I shared clips with you guys, like it has the bags of pastas and the oats and the, you know, more like fresh dry goods, if that makes sense. And so I'm not going to be sharing prices with you guys. Like normally when I do discount grocery hauls, I share like the retail price versus what I paid for it. Since there's so much stuff and there's stuff that is just not like retail, I'm just going to share everything that I got. I will tell you how much I paid for it. Of course, y'all already know I price matched. As I was in there, I was on Walmart app and I was on the Kroger app price matching stuff that I could find prices for. So, of course, I did pick up the things that were the best deals. So, I know I saved money, but I'm not going to take the time and find all the prices and do that stuff. And there's some stuff that I can't do that because it just come from them. So, like I said, I spent $100.31. So, let me get you turned around and I'll share everything that we got. Okay, so here's an overview of everything. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the freezer stuff first so that I can go ahead and get it put in the freezer because some of it needs to be put up. So I got four packages of these little wiener smokies. This is the Hillshire Farms. I was so excited to see these. They did already expire in February, as you've seen. They're frozen and I paid $1.79 per pack. So I got four of those bad boys, and look, they still look perfectly fine. So I was excited to find those. I got two packs of these cheese ravioli. These are the mini rounds. I couldn't find a price on these, but I have seen these in store before, and they're like up to like the $3 and $4 range. So I paid $1.49 per bag, and they do not expire until next year. You'll see the date. I will tell dates. I like to do that as well.
like I've talked about before, dates is just best buy, but it does not mean it's bad. Even if it's frozen food or, you know, shelf stable food, it doesn't bother, it, dates do not bother me. So I got a big thing of the Jimmy Dean sausage. Now this is already frozen. We don't eat a lot of sausage, but since it's already frozen, I can't like cut it up, divide it, and, you know, freeze it. So whenever we go to eat this, I'm going to cook the whole thing and then divide it up and refreeze it cooked, if that makes sense. Because like I said, we don't eat a lot of it, but there's times where I want sausage balls, or I just want a good, you know, country sausage gravy. So, you know, there's times where I do like having it. So I got this 2-pound log for $4.98. And it did already expire in March. But, what was I going to say? I looked it up at Walmart, and for 1 pound at Walmart, it's $4.89. So I got 2 pounds for $4.98. So that's a really good deal. I got some of this Cool Whip. This is the Cool Whip, Whip Mix-Ins. Winston seen this, and he grabbed it. It is out of date, but we're still going to eat it. I think it's like, yeah, September, but we'll see. If it's not any good, you know, I only paid 25 cents for it, so it's not too bad. I got some chicken nuggets. This was a really good deal. This is about the same size that you would get at the regular grocery store, and they're up in, like, y'all know, $3.99 to $8.99 range. So I paid $2.49 for those. Excited to give those a try. And then this one I was super excited about, because y'all know chicken tenders are outrageous. So this is a huge bag of the frozen breaded chicken tenders. And I paid $7.98 for these. And look at how many is in here. Like, I literally just paid for, I just paid like $6 for maybe 10 tenders. So look at all these. So I'm excited about those. And then Winston picked up some Push Pops, $1.98, and they do not expire until August. So those are good. So let me put all of my freezer stuff up, and then we'll come back. Okay, I'm back. So we did pick up some fried pies as well as some muffins. And then y'all seen Winston eating his donut in the store. I did have to pay for this stuff separate, and it was $20.99. But y'all, their stuff is so good. I didn't see any bread. Normally they have bread. I didn't see any, or I would have got some of that. But I got 2 lemon, 2 chocolate, 2 raspberry, and 2 apple of the pies. And then I got 4 of the tuxedo muffins. And then Winston got that 1 chocolate glazed donut. He said it was delicious. So I'm excited to try these. And then I picked up, so like I said, that's separate from the rest of the haul. I got some Kentucky Best bologna. I paid, I got 2 pounds, so I paid $4.89 for it, and looks really good. They cut it good. And then I got 1 pound of the Cajun turkey, and I paid $6.68 for it. I love the Cajun turkey. It's so good. So I got that. And then they had these, you know, it's kind of like, it's just side dishes. I got the Cajun rice and red bean. And it just says how to make it on the back, serving size. But I thought that this would be good to add with some chicken or sausage, you know, an easy meal. And it was only $4.24. So I thought that was cool. I don't know if they make these in-house or what, but, you know, it's pretty cool. And then I got a cheddar broccoli rice one as well. And I'm super excited about that. And then it just says to add the water, the rice in, and cook it. So I thought that was good as well. And I paid $4.38 for that one. Winston picked up some candy corn. He likes candy corn. I don't. He does. So he picked some of that up. And that was $1.89. And then everything else is salvage, well, except for the watermelon. The watermelon was $5.50, So other than that, the rest of this is just salvage stuff. So the prices I paid is what's on the orange sticker. So I got 2 lemon cake mixes. I paid 99 cents for these, and they don't expire until next year, both of them. Winston got some hand sanitizer and chapstick. We paid 99 cents for that. We also got some these little like fun pack things of cereal. I thought that was a good deal. I looked at Walmart, and this was like almost $5 at Walmart, so I paid $2 for it, and they did already expire, but y'all know me, it don't bother me. And then I got some lasagna noodles. This was a really good deal for name brand. I paid 75 cents for these, and they don't expire until 2024. So, and they all look good. They don't, like, there might be a couple broken in there, but they don't look like there's a lot. This back here, I was super excited about. I found a big, it says 3.52 pounds dry milk, y'all. $5 for that much milk. Is that not crazy? I looked it up online, and you can get one of the smaller jars at Walmart for 4 and change. So I got double the amount for a few cents more. This was, I was super, so super excited about. Now, it has already expired, but dry milk is one of those things that it's going to last you forever. So what I'm going to do, since I buy dry milk for emergencies, I'm going to take and put this in a Mylar bag. So that way I know for sure it is going to be good to go, you know, for a few years. I'm not going to have to worry about it. But it did expire in March already. Y'all can't see. There you go, March. So we're going to put that in a Mylar bag and it will be good to go. But that, it was such a good deal, I had to pick that up. I got some cube stuffing. I got the regular cube stuffing, and then I got the cornbread stuffing. I've never seen these before, and it's just the dried stuffing. It doesn't have anything else added to it. You add everything to it. So I thought that was really cool. And I actually had somebody ask me to do a copycat recipe of like stovetop. So I thought this would be good to use for those. So I paid $1.50 for both of these. And this one doesn't expire until May of next year. And this one doesn't, this one doesn't expire until April of next year. So those are good to go. I got 2 of these muffin mixes. This is the wild blueberry. We've had these before. They're really good. Got 2 of them. They do not expire until late into the next year, 8/23. So I paid 99 cents for both of those. I got Luke some fire starters. I did have to look up the price on these because that's something he buys and I wasn't sure. But they're about $4 to $5 for an 18 pack, or for a 16 pack, which is what is here. So that was a really good deal. I paid $2.98 for those. We got some of this chocolate crunch, or chocolate toast crunch remix. We've had the regular one and it's really good. So I thought we would give this chocolate caramel a try, and it was only 75 cents and it expired already in April, but it's good to go. I got some M&Ms. I actually need this for an upcoming video. I needed the red, white, and blue ones. So that was perfect. I paid $2.50 for them, and they already expired in March. Yeah, I had to think what number that was. So March. I got a spring veggie mix. This isn't something I buy often, but I was looking at the recipe on the back and it says spring vegetable quiche. Swiss cheese, add more spinach, add this pack with eggs and milk, mix it all together and put it in a pie crust. Does that not sound amazing? So I picked this up. It was 75 cents and it does not expire until September of next year. So I thought that was a really good deal. These I was super, super excited about, y'all. The Pedialyte, this is such a good thing to keep, you know, in hand on. Let me backtrack. This is something that is really good to keep in your stock or your emergency stock. I normally keep the bottles, but having these powders on hand is, you know, takes up way less space. So I paid $2.25 for both of these packs, and there's six in each one. And they do not expire until August of next year. I grabbed both of those. I was super excited. And it says it's good for kids and adults. This is the orange flavor. So I'm excited about that. That's just going to go straight into my emergency medical supply stock. And we'll have that when we need it, when one of us gets sick or just need the electrolytes. Those are really good to have. I can't remember how much those are at the normal store, but I know they're way more than $2.25. And then I picked up this thing of Gatorade. Now, I'm going to be honest, I'm not sure if this is a good price. I paid $11.40 for it, but Luke has been wanting to try the grape, and we haven't been able to find it at Walmart, or Sam's Club doesn't have it. So when I seen it, I was like, okay, I'm just gonna get it. So I'm not sure if that's a good price. It says that it makes 6 gallons. So I'm not sure. I've never seen it in the bags like these. I've always just seen it in the containers, but it doesn't expire until November of next year. So I have some empty containers, so I'm gonna take and, I can put it in mason jars, and that way he can scoop it out and add it to his drinks. And let's see, I said the watermelon, and then I think the last thing is Cheez-Its. $1.25. Y'all already know that's a heck of a deal. And they don't expire until February of next year. So got those. But that's everything for my Amish and salvage haul. I hope you guys enjoyed this extra bonus haul for this week. And I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys. I'm gonna go eat me a pie.